Hi everyone, it's Sam from SiteMate. In this video, we're going to look at using the list section for managing lists of plant and equipment or vehicles. And it's good to have a centralized list as a source of truth, which your form templates can refer to. But you can also use the list section to manage the details associated with each piece of plant in this case. For example, for managing service due dates and service records and things like that. So you can see we've already got a list of plant and equipment set up. The same would apply if we had a list of vehicles as well. That may even be incorporated into the same list. But then when we open it up, what we're going to get is a list of all of the different pieces of plant. We can see here, so that's this first column where we've got all the list items. And then we've got a bunch of list properties added. So that's these additional columns that you see here. And this is where we can track additional details attached to each of these list items. So for each piece of plant, we can have, in this case, we have a text property for the registration or serial number. We have a column for the next service date. And this is a special type of date property. It's an expiry date property. And what's great about it, as you can see, it color codes these dates based on how far away they are. So for servicing that is not upcoming, it's going to show up in green. Servicing that's within the next 7 days is going to show up in orange. And then if something is overdue, it's going to show up in red. So it's a very easy way of getting a sense for when exactly the next service date is, just by looking at the different colors. And we can actually configure it to send us or someone in your team an automatic email reminder. In this case, you know, 30 days before that date, or once it's overdue, or 7 days before it's due. Basically, we just select the interval, and then we select the person who we want to notify, and then we click update, and that will send an automatic email every time to that relevant person when it is, you know, 7 days away or 30 days away from the date in this column. In addition to that, we can actually upload the service records as PDF attachments. We have a bunch of service records that have been updated. And let's say that, you know, one of these pieces of plant is due for a new service, and we already have a service record from last year that's been uploaded. What we can do is we can just upload an additional PDF attachment. So we can keep all of our service records for that piece of plant or equipment or vehicle all stored in the one place. Keep in mind, you can add as many properties as you'd like. So there may be other details that you want to track, such as the make or model. So you can just add additional properties here. When it comes to getting started with the list section, remember that you can always just import an existing list. So if you have a list of your plant, equipment, or vehicles already, and you've got it in Excel or you've got it in Google Sheets or another software, just save that or export that as a CSV file. And then you can upload that and import that into Dashpivot, and it will auto-populate all of the items. From there, you can start to populate all of the properties, and then you can refer to that list of plant and equipment or vehicles in your form templates, whether it is a vehicle pre-start or plant pre-start, or whether it's a fault report or breakdown report, something like that. You can use the same list of plant and equipment in as many templates as you'd like. And then, you know, the flow-on benefit there is that if you're tracking plant hours, you could use the analytics to then filter for a specific list item, in this case, a specific piece of plant or vehicle. And you can see what the hours look like. We have a specific video that covers this use case in our tutorial section. So definitely head over to the tutorial section if there are some other features or use cases that you'd like to check out. But if you get stuck, you can always reach our team via the live chat down the bottom here on the Dashpivot website and also in the Dashpivot app. So I hope this video has been useful, and thanks for watching.